The new Super Mario Odyssey has a lot of new enemies, however also allies like the Glydon. But have we seen this being before? It looks a lot like another creature, a Yoshi. Could they be related somehow? Well, there is actually some proof for that. Let's dive a little bit deeper. This little dinosaur-like being is extremely enthusiastic about flying, gliding, and screaming. You first meet him in several kingdoms throughout Super Mario Odyssey, and he states that he's traveling to various kingdoms to glide from the highest places. Mario can take control of Glydon to glide and dive. However, when captured, he cannot swim and simply disappears as soon as he touches water. While he is explicitly stated to be an individual character, his name in various Western languages as well as the official Prima Guide for Super Mario Odyssey indicate that Glydon is also the name of his species. However, where did it come from and can it really be related to Yoshi? While some people say that he originates from the Sand Kingdom, this is because of his bandana having similar motifs as the ones found on the ponchos of the Toast Arenas. This is an indication that this is his homeland, and it's also the first kingdom where he can be found in the game. However, does this completely fit? He's not mentioned in the kingdom's brochure, only the Toast Arenas and Moais are put down as the locals. Besides that, his look, overall abilities and design don't really fit this area. However, there's another place in the game that actually fits a lot better. The Lost Kingdom. This is the seventh world you visit, and is the greater location of Forgotten Isles, a large island surrounded by poisoned water. This remote island in the middle of nowhere is actually pretty special. It has isolated all the creatures on it. Not a lot of people have visited these islands because of the surrounding poison, but they are dense with plants and beings that followed a unique evolutionary path. There's a strange unity between the vibrant colored plants, the odd animals, and the sea of poison surrounding them. A great example of a creature that's totally different because of this environment is the tropical wiggler. That actually changed quite a lot. They are not aggressive and are mostly pleasant creatures. However, avoid touching them for safety's sake. They stretch and contract their bodies constantly and have a habit of stretching across major pathways. Clearly a huge change compared to the normal wigglers. Those couldn't extend their bodies at all. Now the reason why they evolved in this way is because of the poison. They need to get around without falling into it, so they turned into these beings over time. But I think the wigglers aren't the only enemies to have changed because of this environment. I think the Glydon was also a very different creature in the beginning. A Yoshi. They are extremely similar to each other in terms of their build. Glydon is a yellow bipedal reptile just like Yoshi. He's taller than Mario, features a long tail, two hands with three fingers and a thumb each, and two rather short legs, which are typically kept significantly bent and almost resting on the bone, resulting in a very peculiar walk. All of this is the exact same as the Yoshi. Even the lighter stripe that goes across his belly and chest are there. They even wear similar shoes to the Yoshis. It's quite obvious that they're related in some way. Now, some aspects are different, but a lot of the creature's figure and overall build are the same. So I'm quite sure that they used to be our screaming friends. They ended up getting two giant membranes on each side, which he uses for gliding, and his head looks a bit different. However, why would they change into a flying creature over time? Well, when you walk around the island, there isn't a lot. No fruits or any food at all. So they most likely grew wings over time and left the island in order to have a better life. That's also why we see them all over the world. Stuff like this happens all the time in real life. Look at Australia. This is a huge island filled with all kinds of weird creatures, and it took thousands of years for them to become like this. A good example is the kangaroos. The females have a pouch in which they will keep the baby, and they're famous for using their very strong hind legs to bounce across the Australian plains. The kangaroo and its smaller relative, the wallaby, use this bouncing to travel great distances, allowing them to survive in the harsh desert conditions of their home country. Another famous Aussie native, the koala is found on the East Coast. Despite appearances and the fact that it's sometimes called a koala bear, it's not actually a bear. They live on nothing but eucalyptus leaves, which makes them very slow and lazy. Some people believe that eucalyptus has a narcotic-like effect on the koalas. A bit like being stoned. Clearly, evolution can work in strange ways. And maybe Nintendo took Australia, or any other island, as an example of weird creatures and evolution. Super Mario Odyssey's theme is highly focused on surprises and travel, and the developers incorporated many of their travel experiences around the world, so it's certainly possible. But how did these, originally Yoshis, end up on this island in the middle of nowhere? Well, there are two options. Number one, they have always been there stuck on that island together with the other creatures. This would mean that it has always been that way, and that this evolution could have taken thousands of years since we have never seen this island before. Number two, the Lost Kingdom is a part of Dinosaur Island where the Yoshis are originally found. Even the Wigglers are seen there. When you're on the island, you can see more forest around it. However, the poison sea stops you from going there. Maybe the poison sea wasn't there at some point, eventually flooded in and trapped the Wigglers, Yoshis, and other creatures there. Over time, they changed in order to survive on this weird island, or to even escape it, since we see some of them all over the world. However, we can't be 100% sure that this is Dinosaur Island, since this would also mean that the evolution happened rather quickly. The time span between most Mario games is not hundreds or thousands of years, so it would have happened rather quickly. And like I mentioned before when I talked about Australia and the evolution seen in that country, it takes some time. So are the glydons really evolved Yoshis? Well, there is a ton of evidence for it, and it would even fit the theme of the game. So I would say yes. And I have to say, the glydons are really cool, and especially with this little detail added. Thanks for watching, everybody. Be sure to check out my Twitter, Instagram, and Twitch. I do all kinds of fun stuff there. You can ask me questions. I do cooking show type stuff on my Instagram. I do a weekly live stream on Twitch. You can ask me any questions on Twitter, and I post fun video game stuff. So go check it out.